You know, when we talk about the statute of limitations up here, I want you to understand exactly what I'm talking about. Because people see the statutes and they say, well, we're in good position right now. Criminally, it's 50, and civilly, it's age 30. But anybody who's in this hall right now, put yourself back in my position as a 13-year-old. You have your childhood best friend waiting outside the bathroom door because that's where the priest told him to wait. And then you get raped. 13 years old. Do you think when I was in that shower that I knew what a statute of limitations was? 13 years old. And then I find out that my statutes, where I had only 5 years criminally to come forward and two civilly, at age 13 in 1983. That is unacceptable. And then I find out that my parish knew that this priest was abusing kids and he was at 10, 12 different parishes before he came to my school. So to be honest with you, I don't give a crap what the statute of limitation is. Because as soon as they committed the crime to cover it up, the statute of limitation should have been removed. That's what is right. There has to be serious change here in Pennsylvania that puts victims on the same playing field as perpetrators. And the only cause of action is to completely eliminate the statute of limitations, civil and criminal, moving forward. But before we do that, we have to give our victims from the past their voice. And the only way they can accomplish that is through a court of law. I know when I go to bed at night, I can sleep well. There may not be people in this hall that can. It's unacceptable. $5 million has been allocated in our state budget to ensure the Pope's safety this week in Philadelphia. Hours were spent in last month's mock House session decrying how we don't care about funding for rape victims, and yet not one finger has been lifted in the past 10 years by our leaders to enact laws which will actually stop the culture of abuse in this Commonwealth. As Lynn Abraham noted, the one recommendation from the grand jury in 2005, and the most important to victims of childhood sex abuse, is to open the window. That is the only thing that will give victims the justice they deserve.